Hello, we're here still working on this stupid thing, the Star Destroyer. This is the building section. It's been changed quite a bit since the last time you've seen it, and I'll show you some of the newly detailed parts that I've done for it. Okay? Alright, here we go. So what I've done a little differently on this model is made it easier to build as far as the parts, but I've also made it a few more parts like these pieces here. Now, I'm not going to say that I'm going to do it, but I've done all these pieces separately because I want to try to mold them in clear. Not only just for doing them in clear, but to get the detail better, you know, when you mold it. So basically, all the pieces here, all these newly detailed pieces back here, as you can see, a bit more stuff on them. No, maybe not so much that one. You know, all these will be separate. And if the clear part works out, I'll offer a clear package, but it'll probably be like $300 added on to the original price because the resin is very expensive, the clear stuff, and it takes three times as long to cure, so time is money as well. But anyways, this is the back of the head. I had to, since I cut the head down through here to make it thinner this way, to make it more correct, I had, you know, there's a line that cut through here, so I added some detail to the edges. Kind of added a little more techie stuff here and there to make it look a little more interesting, as well as these blocks for the antenna. I've added more detail to those, as you can see, or maybe you can't see. You have to compare it with the other pieces. And of course, the new face, which is, I made a little more dimensional. It was a bit flat before, so you can kind of get the idea where we're going with this. Now the antenna has been completely revamped as well. It's got these kind of these strips I noticed. I don't know if it was on maybe Rogue One. That's what I liked about it. It has this sort of this angle right here that kind of goes in, which I really like. And you got, of course, these pieces here, which will glue on top and bottom like that. So I'm going to make a piece. Where is it? This is kind of the beginning of it. This little piece here is an optional piece that will glue in here somewhere. I'm still working on it, which will be able to make the antenna set up like this if things work out, which I think it will. As you can see, it's two-sided now instead of just one-sided like the old one. And I redid the detail a little bit too to make it a little nicer. That's what's happening with that so far. Just have to finish down here. As you can see, it looks like dog shit. And that should be it. That should take care of that. It should all be done by tomorrow, finally. The head comes off here. Whoa! Those pieces, let those fall. Those will be separate, obviously. Get some close-ups of these things, photos, so you can see the details. So this will all be one piece, basically. Mold it just like that. Minus the pencil. That's how it'll be cast and molded. So this will all be one piece, which will be nice. Then you got this piece here, which will sort of be one piece. That's be a big ass mold, but it'll make it so much easier to build. And whether or not you want these cast and clear or not, providing it works, is of course up to you. It'll save a ton of time on doing fiber optics and all that shit. So anyways, that's it for this thing so far. I hope they have that part of the building done finally. This thing's been sitting here long enough, forever and a day. Little parts in there. Had this little engine made. Had somebody print it out for me, because it's just, well, if anybody's seen the old engine, it, well, to put it in the simplest term I can, kind of blows dog compared to the new one. Let's get that out of there. It's not even, you know, it's all handmade. It's over 10, 11 years old now, and the sides here are a little lumpy, because the way I made it back in the day, where this grown piece is very nice and clean. Separate rings piece, and I like how the guy did all that little, those little teeth in there. Kind of off of, episode 7, I guess, you know? So I think it'll make a much better looking engine. So I had this guy do a couple things for me. He made a little Falcon, but I'm not going to sell that with the kit. You can buy it from them, though, as well as a little blockade runner that I was showing you pictures of earlier. You know, it doesn't show you much. So anyways, that's it for now. It's hot as hell out here. We just had some rain, now it's a steam bath out here. So I'm going to go take a shower and get out of this shit. And who knows when the next video is done. Hopefully
when the whole top section's done, which hopefully won't be a couple weeks. This thing's been sitting way too long. Working, life must intrude, you know. So anyways, talk to you later. Bye. Well, here it is, the building section, finally done. The pebble in my shoe now removed. There's the head. I'll try to get close enough for you to see the new bridge. Yeah, see, there's the bridge. I put the triangle windows in it, so you can, I'll see them in there. That's the antenna, obviously, in the up position. So I made this little piece, kind of techy looking. They just had a couple of little tubes that ran up to it. But I decided to make this thing so you can leave it off if you want to lay it flat. Or leave it on. It's up to you. Change a little bit of detailing in here if needed. As well as the garbage dump thing right there. Go this way so you can see how it's gonna look. Wide shot. Some new detail here and there to pop a little more. The old detail was 10 years old, so it was a bit soft. That's why I decided to up it just a little bit. I didn't color it too far outside the lines.